In this video, I'll show you several examples on how to evaluate algebraic terms containing fractional exponents without a calculator. The question reads, evaluate in radical form without a calculator. So for our first one, we have 4 to the power of 3 over 2. To do this effectively, you have to be mindful of the fact that this 3 over 2 can actually be broken down as a product of two numbers. For example, 4 to the power of half times 3. 4 to the power of half times 3 is the same thing as 4 to the power of 3 over 2. And similarly, 4 to the power of half to the power of 3 is also the same. So I'm going to draw an arrow that indicates that all of these expressions are the same. Now, why would this one be of importance to us? Remember that if you have, let's say, for example, x to the power of half, that is the same thing as saying the square root of x. So in our case here, we have the square root of 4 to the power of 3. Now we all know what the square root of 4 is. It's positive 2, and 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 8. That's the answer to our first one, and that's the approach we are going to use for every other question. Let's take, for example, this one. Now you'll notice that this right here is a quotient, it's a fraction, and we have negative 3 to the power of 2. Unfortunately, our exponent is a negative. But there's a tool you can use if you ever run into a situation like this. The tool is the following. A over b to the power of negative c is the same thing as saying b over a to the power of positive c. So by using this little tool right here, we actually make this question a lot easier for us. Our question now suddenly becomes 4 over 25 to the power of positive 3 over 2. Once again, I'm going to use the same technique as before. I'm going to separate this into 4 over 25, that part hasn't changed, to the power of half to the power of 3. The reason why this is ideal for us now is because if you remember the laws of exponents, if you have a quotient and it is set to a power, this half will actually be distributed to every term within that quotient. Now remember, half is a radical, it's the square root. So we're finding the square root of 4 over the square root of 25, all to the power of this 3. The square root of 4 is 2, as established in the previous question, and the square root of 25 is 5. So what we have is we have 2 to the power of 5 to the power of 3, and we're going to use that same rule where we distribute this to all the components within the quotient. 2 to the power of 3 is 8, and 5 to the power of 3, this one's a little hard to do without a calculator, but doesn't hurt to memorize. 5 to the power of 3 is 125, and that is in its most reduced form. Let's move on to question C. This time we have 32 to the power of 3 over 5. Now once again, we can separate 3 over 5. 32 to the power of 1/5 to the power of 3. 32 to the power of 1 over 5 is the same thing as saying the fifth root of 32. In other words, what number can we multiply in itself 5 times that will get us 32? Now, of course, don't forget this 3. Haven't forgotten that. So have you thought of a number that when multiplied in itself 5 times gives you 32? If you thought 2, you're right. The fifth root of 32 is in fact 2. 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 8. And that is the final answer. Let's move on to our last example. Here we have 49 over 16, all set to the power of negative 5 over 2. Now to do this question, we're going to use that technique that we used above, where this 16 and 49 switch positions. And now this becomes positive 5 over 2. The next step is to separate this 5 over 2 into a product, where we have 16 over 49 to the power of half to the power of 5. Notice that if we use the power of a power rule in the laws of exponents, you would multiply these two and you would end up with 5 over 2 once again. Now I will distribute this half to both of these, and distributing a half to a term is the same thing as having a radical. The square root of 16 is 4, and the square root of 49 is 7. And that is to the power of 5. Now, of course, 4 to the power of 5 is a big number, and so is 7 to the power of 5. So 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 can be evaluated, and so can the 7. But without wasting too much time, you will get a pretty big number here and a big number here if you do it manually. But in this particular case, chances are your teacher will not ask you to multiply all of this out and will be content with simply this expression. So there you have it. Four examples on how to evaluate algebraic terms containing fractional exponents. If you found this tutorial helpful, please support our channel by subscribing or by liking this video. If you have any further questions, visit our website at studyforce.com. We're an online service for students seeking free homework help. See you soon.